Let's get started. The topic for today, I think in general, is male and female roles in dancing. And also kind of from our experience gained what we feel like is important as to dancing and being specific about the role that we play when we dance together, because typically ballroom dancing has celebrated the idea of gender opposition or just opposition in general, having dynamics in everything, high, low, fast, slow, side to side, and as well in our partnership. And so understanding and recognizing the things that help us stand apart to then come together as a whole helps us when we dance to know kind of how we can fit into that role. So let's start from the anything you want to add to what I said. First of all, the first thing all men need to know is we never should silence our partner. Always give them a place to speak, because we usually forget everything anyway. So partner dancing. We have all levels of dancing, right? We have social dancing, we have syllabus dancing, we have open dancing, all of which I think uniquely came from, let's say, just freestyle dancing. We step into partner dancing where all of a sudden we go from dancing by ourselves to then asking a partner to come and dance in contact with us in some way, whether it's here or here. And then we translate that to ballroom dancing in a group and competing, and that's a big jump. But we think that a lot of the ideals that started here translate to ballroom and then to smooth. And so we want to talk about just a few of those basic ideas and how they relate, and then we want to give you, if we have time, a small piece of choreography in Foxtrot and have everybody kind of practice that, and then you can also translate that into your own dancing. So, for the men, what I'd like to talk about is, in a general sense, I myself don't think that dancing should be overpowering from one person or another. We are a 50-50 blend of a couple. And so I, in my own dancing, feel like I invite the lady to do everything, and I don't tell her what to do. And I think that's true in life. I think in life we're happiest when we're asking each other to do things, and then we comply and we say, okay, let's go together. So when I'm dancing, I feel like, especially in competitive dancing, I try to do everything I can to present my partner to the audience. And that is natural to the first time we take hold. I'm holding my partner in my frame, presenting her not only for myself, but others around, right? And this, to me, is very important. Having the concept of the men from that basic hold, we have something very important. We have eye contact, and we have a frame. And we talk about this all the time. From the very beginning, we talk about this frame that we're creating and how we're presenting our partner. So I think it's obvious in closed dance position in ballroom, we still maintain that idea of this frame. And everything we do presents our partner as much as we can. But now, even more so important, when we go to these open positions, as a male dancer, as much as I can, I want to try and always continue to take this dance hold and extend that into space. So as I am dancing, as much as I can, I'm always trying to give reference to my partner so that no matter what, if somebody, for whatever reason, wants to watch me, they'll immediately want to be turned to watching my partner because of the actions that I'm doing, physically and visually. My cues are to frame my partner, so if we're dancing apart, my body language is directed toward her, and as much as possible, my eye contact as well. So that if you as a spectator are watching, you see everything that I do draws the attention and focus to my partner. I still have an ethereal frame that is framing her from a distance, if that makes sense. So as much as I can. So in American Smooth, we have a lot of choreography that might bring us side by side. It might even have us turn back to back occasionally. As much as possible, I want to try and use my body language to always be shaping toward my partner with eye contact. Even when looking away, I want to try and have my eye contact be directed toward her and my posture in a way that it would direct your eye to my partner. So that even at the last minute, I'm still watching her, telling everybody, this is my focus. That is the basis of what I would like to lay out today in our lecture and in our small section of choreography that we do. Anything you want to add to what you want the men do?
Yeah, I mean, ultimately it's all about the ladies.
I mean, did you guys see that? Is there anything else you want me to do, honey? I mean, that's really what it comes down to.
Exactly. No, kind of going along with what Travis is saying, Smooth, in my opinion, can be a very chaotic style because not only are we separating away from our partner, which you may do in rhythm in Latin, but in addition to that, every single dance we do also travels around the space of the floor, right? So you do have those dances in, the Paso Doble, right, and Samba, but that's only two out of the five dances. But every single Smooth dance is not only working in our own circular space, but it's also traveling around the room. So if we are not aware of our partner and kind of always redirecting our energy and creating a clear awareness of who is dancing with who, sometimes it can feel like there's just bodies on the dance floor and just moving randomly around. And so it is very important to have not only that visual focus, but also that awareness of kind of guiding and allowing our bodies to dance with and towards our partner, even if we are not touching each other, okay? Now, one thing that for the ladies that I think is important to remember is while we are doing something that is competitive, we are also doing something that is an art form, right? And so we want to try to make our gestures and our body actions kind of as beautiful as possible. So in general, like if we just look at references from art or fashion or say like the red carpet, you very rarely see women just like this in a pose, right? We always see women kind of like creating nice like curves from the body and like, you know, looking like over their shoulder rather than standing very squarely, unless you're trying to make like a specific point. And so you see that in, you know, Renaissance art, that's like a much more advanced form than say like your early hieroglyphic art, right? So we want to make sure that we're kind of creating more beautiful lines for us as a lady, right? We have curves and we want to make sure that we're sort of, as we're dancing through space, allowing ourselves to show those off and trying not to get, you know, too square where everything is a little bit too lined up. So that's what I'm going to be focusing on a little bit as we go through this sequence together, is making sure that for us as ladies, we're always using and presenting ourselves in a very feminine, female way that is very inviting, but still has an awareness towards our partner as well.
We're gonna do a short section of choreography, most of which will be side by side. So we'll wanna talk about, when we're not touching, how to still maintain that masculine and feminine role in our dancing, even if we're doing the same steps, okay? So first we're gonna demonstrate and then we'll start breaking it down and then we'll talk as we go, okay? So here's what it will look like.
Okay.
So we will walk, we will do a 1, 2, a 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. 1, 3, 4, okay? Second nature to us, and also helps keep pulling us away from just thinking about the smallest little detail. Helps us focus on our partner, which draws us to something that's ultimately really important on the dance floor, which we call chemistry. when you watch people dance on the dance, or if they're on screen or if they're on a stage, we talk about chemistry. And chemistry, the foundation of chemistry, is what we're talking about. Two people looking at each other, having a conversation. We are doing it non-verbally, but we pass, let's say, a ball back and forth between each other with our body language, where I pass her something and she passes it back to me. And so if we're not looking at each other, we totally miss that opportunity to have this very human interaction with our partner that ultimately is the thing that we want people to see. We don't, in the end, don't always win a competition with the best heel lead on the floor or the best lowering action. We win it with a combination of things, and this is really, in the end, what connects with everybody, I think. So.
Yeah. There's one more note about that. Even though your eyes are a pretty small part of your body, they carry a lot of power. Like, when you think about it, if you're having a conversation with somebody and the entire time you're talking to them, they just keep looking down, eventually you start to go,
what do I have on my shirt?
Or like, oh, something in my teeth. Like, you know it because the way they keep glancing in that direction is drawing and your focus and your energy there. So it is very important that, again, we're not just like kind of like glassy-eyed looking there. There's a lot of power when you allow yourself to, like I said, see your partner. Not just look in their direction, but actually see them. Okay? And then when they see you back and that creates a connection, it's like a very, very powerful thing. Two, three. Now, as I'm turning, I'm actually still moving a little bit diagonally forward. Diagonally forward. And that allows me, when I finish, to, if you notice, we're on two separate tracks, not actually side by side.
This,
okay?
This
so from
also
the front, when somebody's looking at you, they see two people side by side. But if somebody's looking at you from the side as you're coming down the floor, again, they still see two people, two individuals, not just one.
This also gives a chance for the men to keep the ladies in their field of vision easily, so that I can always, one, be watching a nice looking girl, but two, I'm also telling the audience where I want my focus and where I want their focus with your partner. We can do the first step point and have our standing leg settle into the hip that we want so that we're here with our right hip up. Or we can also do it where we accentuate and lift the left hip. So this will be in coordination with your partner and what feels comfortable and what looks good on you.
What feels good.
Yeah,
level also works. We like to work in polarity. We feel like it makes a greater contrast, but neutral will also work. It just depends on what looks good on you and your partner.
Yeah. I mean, the nice thing about moments like this is it does give you a lot of, like, artistic freedom, right? So you don't have to, not every single lady in the room has to do the exact same arms or the exact same way of moving her hips. But what I want you to do is I want you to explore and try things. The most important thing is that in these moments we have a conversation with our partner and go, how are you doing it? Okay, should I match you and also do, you know, a lifted hip? Or should I contrast you and do a different shaping so that we create something that gives, you know, a unique look to it? So that's where you have a little bit of freedom of expression to choose what feels best, most natural in your body, and just working to coordinate that with your partner. Okay?
So we're now coming to the end of our lecture. But how about we do this? Since we didn't get all the way to the end, how about we will video what we just did, and then you can take it home and analyze it, and we'll try and give you, we'll dance it so that you can actually see it. And,